Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Math School Learn to Succeed. In this channel, I'll be teaching you Karnataka Board Class 10th SLC NCERT Math. So in today's video, let us solve the question number 6 and 7 from exercise 1.2, chapter number 1, Arithmetic Progressions. In my previous video, I have solved the questions 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. If you have not watched that video, please find the link in the description box below or click the I button above. So before we begin the video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit the bell button below to get the latest updates of my videos. So question number 6 from exercise 1.2 says, check whether minus 150 is a term of AP. So here, if you notice that we have to determine whether minus 150 is a term of this AP or not. Let us first assume let minus 150 be the nth term of AP. We don't know which term of AP is minus 50, so we are initially assuming it to be the nth term, and we have to find out n value to check whether minus 150 is the term of AP or not. So from the given AP, we can see that A value, this first term, that is A11, and D value can be found out, that is A2 minus A1. So the second term A2 is 8 minus 11. So D is equal to minus 3. Now what is the nth term formula that is given by An is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. I have explained this formula in the nth term of an AP introduction. If you have not watched that video, please find the link in the description box below or click the I button above. So coming to this formula, let us substitute the values and find out the n value. So an value is minus 150 is equal to a is 11 plus n, we have to find out n minus 1 into d is minus 3. So minus 150 is equal to 11 minus 3n. If you open the brackets, so minus into minus is plus 3, so minus 150 is equal to 11 plus 3 is 14 minus 3n, or if you transfer this 14 to the left hand side, we get minus 14 is equal to minus 3n. If you add 150 and 14, we get 0 plus 4 is 4, 5 plus 1 is 6 and 1. So it is minus 164 is equal to minus 3n, or n is equal to minus 164 divided by minus 3. So minus and minus will become plus. We cannot further simplify as 164 is not divisible by 3. So here we can notice that the n value we have found out to be a fraction. So one important thing we should observe here, that the n value can never be a fraction or a negative number. It should always be a positive counting number. So keep this in mind. This is very important, guys. Let me write down, the n value should always be a positive number. It cannot be a fraction or a negative number. So this is very important. You have to keep in mind. Since here we got the n is equal to 164 by 3 and it is a fraction, we can say that 150 is not a term of AP. Since we got n value as the fraction, we can say that therefore minus 150 is not a term of AP. Now, seventh question of exercise 1.2 says, find the 31st term of an AP whose 11th term is 38 and 16th term is 73. So first of all, let us write down what is given here. So they are asking us, find the 31st term of an AP. So we have to find a 31 value. Given that the 11th term A11 is equal to 38, and the 16th term, that is A16, is 73. So we have to find out the 31st term of the AP. Okay, so let us first of all write down the formula for the nth term of an AP. So the nth term of an AP is given by An is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So in the first, so here they have told us the 11th term of AP is 38. So let us substitute these values in this formula. Now let us substitute the n value and the 11th term value in the formula. So A11 is equal to A plus 11 minus 1 into d. What is the 11th term value? That is nothing but 38. So let us write down 38 is equal to a plus 11 minus 1 is 10d. Okay, similarly, when we substitute a16 is equal to 73 in the equation, in the formula, so this we can take it as equation 1. Now substituting again here, a16 is equal to a plus, what is n value here, 16 minus 1 into d, or a16 value is 73 is equal to a plus 15d. So let this be the second equation. Now using this equation 1 and equation 2, we can find out the a and d value by elimination method. Therefore, by elimination method we get 38 is equal to a plus 10d and 73 is equal to a plus 15d. Here we can observe that in both the equation the coefficient of a is 1. Therefore we can cancel this term by changing the sign. This be minus, again this will be minus. If this is plus and plus, this will become minus. So cancelling the a term, we can subtract here 38 minus 73. 73 minus 38 we get 13 minus 8 is 5 and 6 minus 3 is 3. So it is minus 73 and plus 38, so greater number sign we have to put here. So it is minus 35 is equal to minus 10 minus 15 is 5d, or d value will be equal to, this minus and minus will become plus, 35 by 5, or d is equal to 7. Okay, now let us substitute this d value in the equation 1 and obtain the a value. So substitute d is equal to 7 in equation 1. So we get 38 is equal to a plus 10 into 7, or 38 is equal to a plus 70. When 70 is transferred to the left hand side, it will become minus 70 plus 38. So if we subtract 70 minus 70 and 38, we get 10 minus 8 is 2. This will become 6 minus 3 is 3. So that will be a is equal to minus 32. So we got a and d value. Now let us find out the 31st term of an AP. Now let us find out the 31st term of an AP by substituting a and d value. So in the 31st term of AP, we have to find out where n is equal to 31, a is equal to minus 32, and d is equal to 7. So let us substitute in the nth term formula again. So a 31 we have to find out is equal to a is minus 32 plus n is 31 minus 1 into d is 7. So that will be minus 32 plus 30 into 7, or it is minus 32 plus 7 zeros are 0, 7 threes are 21. So subtracting minus 32 from 210 we get, so 210 minus 32, 10 minus 2 is 8, and 21 minus 3 is 70. So we get A31 is equal to 178. So 31st term of an AP is 178. Therefore the 31st term of AP is equal to 178. In my next video, I'll be solving the question number 8 from exercise 1.2. So till then, please like and share my video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.